Minister for Environment, Science and Technology, Professor Frimpong Boateng, raised concerns over the health implications for consumers who eat SCOBY preserved with formalin. This prompted the Food and Drugs Authority to begin investigations into the alleged practice. Head of Food Safety at the FDA, Mariam Lovelace Johnson, said the authority dealt with the issue of formalin used to preserve products in 2015. Mariam Lovelace said consumption of the formalin-preserved fish has dire health consequences and warned people in the business to stop or face the full rigors of the law.
It's a preservative for corpses. It is not edible. It's not meant for food. It must not be used for food because it's carcinogenic. Even people who just inhale them at certain doses have issues. Anyone who uses it contravenes the Public Health Act, Act 851, Section 100, Subsection 3, A, B, and E.
She advised people in the business to abide by the two best ways of preserving SCOBY, which is simpler and less expensive.
Drying and salting. The drying of the SCOBY reduces the water activity of the fish. Salting in itself is also another means of preservation. Many microorganisms cannot tolerate salts. The very few ones that are salt tolerant, or as we call them, halotolerant, will not be even available to spoil the fish.
We followed up to the market to find out whether traders in the SCOBY business are aware of the purported poisonous substance used in preserving salted fish.
Salted fish, otherwise known as SCOBY in the local parlance, is a delicacy for many Ghanaians. We are told that they use salt in preserving it. But recently we are told again that they use formalin, which is a poisonous chemical, in preserving this delicacy. And this has become a worry to many Ghanaians.
Helen Ayibunte has been selling SCOBY for 20 years and confirms the use of formalin in preservation. She claims she is able to tell the difference between the salted SCOBY from the formalin-preserved SCOBY. SCOBY that is preserved with formalin melts when it is cooked. Sometimes consumers come with such complaints, so I also change the trader I buy from. Her daily sales, she laments, has dropped. As the results from the Food and Drugs Authority are yet to be publicized, consumers of this delicacy are advised to be cautious. AC Benewanyame, TV3, Accra.